in order to deny the invading Germans access to this road as an easy way in to and from Crowborough, these anti-tank cylinders were placed on the bridge to force the German tanks and vehicles off of the road and to try and cross the river somewhere. I haven't counted these, but after the war, obviously, when the roads were cleared again, these were just, looks like they were just rolled over the edge. But these ones have been used to reinforce the riverbank here. And there as well. Some of them are in great condition, most of them. And I think these metal poles here were also part of the defensive barricade. There's some on the other side of the bridge as well, actually submerged. Some you can't see, they're actually under the water. Another reminder of the world's recent dark history. I suppose, being more or less in the middle of nowhere, now people drive past and don't give a second thought how important this position was back in the 1940s. And there are the metal poles laying on the riverbed there. It may or may not have had something to do with the cylinders. Maybe it's how they were linked together. Maybe that's how they moved them. But a peaceful country lane now.